Hi guys and welcome back to another video. So today I'm testing out the Adidas Nemesis 19 Plus. And even though the Nemesis is one of the most innovative products from Adidas, it's one that the football world has struggled to accept, especially compared to the X, the Copa, and the Predator. So we're gonna discuss a few reasons why I think that might be, as well as talk about a few new updates they've made to the 19 Plus. But first things first, let's take them out for a spin. Adidas launched the Nemesis line back in 2017 with the idea of creating a football boot entirely made out of athletic tape on the upper. And they've continued that theme on the 19 Plus, but as we can see here, the strips of athletic tape are a lot wider this time. On previous models, the 17 Plus and the 18 Plus, we had a higher frequency of strips, so we saw more seams on the forefoot. Now we can only see one big seam here to separate two large strips of athletic tape, so it does provide a bit of a cleaner surface, a bit more distractionless, especially when dribbling the ball and striking the ball, you feel a lot more connection between the ball and your foot. As you can see closely here, there is a separation between this forefoot area, and then as we move up into this area here where we insert the foot, it's pretty much just raw athletic tape. So at the front it's going to be very stiff, not very flexible, but it's going to be the complete opposite up the top here. As you can see, moves around very freely, very pliable material up the top. It's a very small hole to get your foot in, and I actually had to use a shoehorn for the first time. I've never had to use a shoehorn to get any football boot on in my life. Then once my foot was in there, it did hug the foot really nicely. All this material here wrapped around the ankle, and I felt like it was a very snug fit. They also have another band of tape just inside the area where you put your foot in, lays over the top of the foot, and at first it is very tight. I noticed my foot was cramping for the first 30 minutes or so of using the football boots, but after you get used to it, it's a very snug fit, which I did quite enjoy. They have reinforced the heel a little bit towards the bottom. It's quite stiff at the back here, so even though it's very pliable, flexible material on the sides, it's a bit more rigid to keep your heel locked in place, and then you have this external heel counter as well to offer a little bit more support. The sole plate is also new on the Nemesis 19 Plus. They're using something what they're calling a torsion system, and they're using a split sole plate this time. As you can see from the stub pattern itself, the majority are conical, some of them more oval than others, and then in the center of the boot, we've got an arrowhead stud as well, just to offer a bit more purchase when you're accelerating off the ground. The sole plate itself seems pretty responsive, nice bit of snap when you're accelerating and pushing that ground away. I didn't have any problems with the sole plate, it seemed very aggressive. So obviously because this is the 19 Plus model, there are no laces whatsoever. Instead of laces, we kind of have these multi-layers of athletic tape that are supposed to provide a secure fit. Once your foot's in there, they wrap over each other and provide a little bit more reinforcement to keep your foot nice and secure in the boot. There are a couple of things about the Nemesis 19 that I really like as far as performance. First being the thinness of the upper. It really provides a personal, close feel on the ball when you're dribbling. You do feel razor sharp with the ball at your feet. As well on the upper, I like the strike surface as well. Pretty much from any laceless boot, you're going to have a distractionless upper, so it does provide a nice, clean striking surface, and I've always enjoyed the experience of shooting in a laceless boot. Another thing I really enjoy about the Nemesis 19 Plus is the comfort. And comfort isn't something you come to expect from a synthetic boot, but because of this athletic tape that's so stretchy and flexible, it really wraps around your foot and expands, so it's not restricting. But with the flexibility of this athletic tape does come a negative side as well. When you're changing directions and all your weight is going to the side of the boot, it's not providing much rigidity, not much response. It pretty much just bends with your foot. So if you're planting your foot and changing sharply, you do feel like your foot kind of moves with the boot. And because of the absence of laces, you're not able to provide extra lockdown or customize the feel of the boot to suit your preferences. It's pretty much exactly how it's gonna feel from the first time you put your foot in the boot. As I'm sure you guys know, the Nemesis line does include a 19.1, which does have laces, which I'm sure will provide a bit more lockdown. But just for me personally, this athletic tape doesn't provide enough rigidity. For me as a player who likes to twist and turn and change direction a lot, having a football boot that feels responsive where my foot is fully locked down is very important to me personally. So if that's important to you as well, I wouldn't recommend the Nemesis for that experience. But overall, it is an interesting boot, and I really do appreciate the innovation that Adidas are putting into their football boots, trying to do something different. But different isn't always a good thing. And I think that goes to show why the Nemesis hasn't made much of a splash in the football world, with only a few top level pros wearing them, who probably have a customized variation of the boot to provide a little bit more lockdown and responsiveness. On top of that, it's just hard to place where the Nemesis is. Obviously, Adidas have produced the Copa, the X, and the Predator, which have very specific characteristics. And even though it's kind of a combination of all of them, because it does provide comfort, it's got some characteristics of a speed boot, it doesn't really excel in any of those areas for me. It's kind of very average in all the categories. If you're spending $275 to $300 on a pair of football boots, I'd recommend getting something that's a bit more value for money, that's going to offer you more performance. But nevertheless, I really enjoyed testing out the Nemesis 19 Plus, and I just want to say a huge thank you to Pro Direct Soccer for providing the boots. And if you do want to get a pair for yourself, I'm going to leave a link in the description box below, which will take you to their website. But let me know what you guys thought of the boots. That's just my opinion, but I want to know what your opinion is as well. Let me know in the comments section below. But if you did enjoy today's video and you do want to see more boot tests on the channel, make sure you hit that like button. Also, hit that subscribe button for weekly training videos, and I will see you guys in my next video.